Hello, welcome to you all. Welcome to my channel in Mechanical Engineering Concept. Today I am going to discuss about case study of a cotter joint, in which I am going to discuss a cotter joint design procedure with respect to a given condition. So here I am going to consider a case study. It is required to design a cotter joint to connect two steel rod of equal dia. Each rod is subjected to an axial tensile force of 40 kN. Design the joint and calculate its dimension. So in this case study, I am going to design a cotter joint, each component, and with respect to the design procedure is based on the failure of each component for a load condition of 40 kN tensile. So given data is load P is equal to 40 kN. It is given to us. In step one, first we need to select a material to design a cotter joint. So first we need to know that the basic material which is used to design a cotter joint. So cotter joint is designed on with the basis of the cotter joint is designed with the material of plain carbon steel. Here I am considering plain carbon steel of grade 30C8, which has a yield tensile strength of 400 Newton per m square. And another assumption I am going to take is SYT is equal to SYC divided by 2, yield compressive strength is equal to 2 times of yield tensile strength. This data is taken from design data book VV Bhandari 2.25 number page and table number 2.26. This value is taken from design data book VV Bhandari 2.25 page number and table number 2.26. After selection of material, we need to take a factor of safety for further design. So for taking or for selection of factor of safety, we further take a design data book VV Bhandari page number 4.19, table number 4.16. In that, for ductile material steel type, we take factor of safety of 2 for socket and spigot, and for cotter we take a factor of safety 3. In step 3, after the selection of factor of safety and material, we calculate the permissible stresses has to be calculated. So to calculate permissible stresses for rod, socket and spigot, we take a tensile stress is equal to yield strength divided by factor of safety, which is taken from the first theory of failure, from Rankine theory, or we can say that a maximum principal stress theory. To calculate sigma t, SYT has been taken from data book 400 for 30C8 plain carbon steel, and factor of safety for rod, socket and spigot is taken as 2. So the tensile stress will be come out as a 200 Newton per m square. After calculating tensile stress, we need to calculate compressive stress also. To calculate compressive stress is same as a tensile stress. We need to take a SYC divided by FOS. So we know that as per the assumption, SYC is a twice of SYT. So SYT is 400 and twice of the SYT is SYC, so 2 times of 400 divided by 2. So sigma c compressive stress will be come out as a 400 Newton per m square. After calculating sigma c, shear stress will be calculated on the basis of shear strength, yield shear strength divided by factor of safety, on the basis of second theory of failure, which says that maximum shear stress theory, or we can say that guest and Tresca theory. we said SYT divided by 2FS or 0.5 times of SYT divided by FOS. Putting the SYT value here and FOS, we calculate the shear stress as a 100 Newton per m square. After calculating permissible stresses for rod and stock and spigot, we need to calculate permissible stresses for cotter also. So for cotter, sigma t will be 133.3 megapascal or Newton per m square, or and tau will be come out as a 66.6 megapascal or Newton per m square. After the calculation of a permissible stresses, in step 4 we are going to design a each component of a cotter joint. First I am going to design a rod, because the rod has a simplified dimension, circular section, so it is easy to design a rod. So on the basis of ease, or for design calculation, or for design simplification or calculation, we need to take first simplified dimension for design purpose. So first, design of a rod. If we apply tensile force on a rod, the tensile force of the rod will fail the component in circular section. The resisting area will be 5/4 d square, so sigma t will be load upon area, as we discussed already in a design procedure of cotter joint. So sigma t is equal to load upon area, area will be 5/4 d square, d is the circular section of a rod. Here we know sigma t, we already calculated sigma t, and load will be given to us in a case study problem, 40 kN. Putting that value in that equation, the diameter will be come out as a 15.95 mm, which can be round off as a 20 mm for a design simplification or calculation simplification. Further, after calculating a design, after calculation of diameter of rod, in step 5, design of a spigot is taken. In a design of a spigot, first I am going to consider a failure of a spigot due to tension. The spigot section due to tension will be fail load upon area. This formula we will calculate it already in a design procedure of a cotter joint. Load upon area. Area will be pi for d2. D2 is the outer dia. D2 is the dia of a spigot. T is the thickness of a slot in which the cotter will be fitted. Pi/4 d2 square minus d2 into t. Here we need to calculate d2 and t for a spigot design. So here two unknowns are there, because p and sigma t already we know. So to calculate d2 and t, first we need to consider empirical relation. T is equal to 0.3 times of d. Small d is the dia of a rod or a circular section which we already designed or which we already calculated. So with the respect of this small d, we calculated t with respect to this empirical relation. T is equal to 6 mm, which we rounded off as a 10 mm. So after calculation of t, we can put here t this in this equation. So we can calculate from this t, p and sigma t, with respect to that we can calculate d square. D square will be come out as a 23.52 mm, which we can round it off for design simplification or calculation simplification, 30 mm. After calculating spigot diameter, further another dimension we will need to calculate for a spigot. So to calculate that, another step in a design of a spigot, failure of spigot due to shearing we will be considering. So shear stress is equal to load upon area. This formula is already we discussed in a cotter joint design procedure. Area will be 2d2 into a. 2 will be come out here due to double shearing. Tau we will be calculated, p is given to us. D2 we already calculated, and a we need to calculate for spigot. So putting all those values, we come out as a area A, sorry, A will be equal to, small a will be equal to 6.66 mm. Further, in step 4, part C, spoil god crushing we will be considering, or failure due to crushing of a spoil god we consider for considering whether the design of a spoil god is safe enough to bear the load of 40 kN or not. Because we already designed or calculated the dimensions of the spoil god cross section, so we need to further consider that dimension of a spoil god section is safe enough to bear the load of 40 kN or not. If it is safe enough, then we need to design another component. If it will not, then we need to design again to bear a load of 40 kN. So for that, we need to consider crushing of a spoil god. So in this point, I am going to discuss about how we can calculate, how we can say whether the design is safe enough or not to bear a load. So as we know that stress is equal to load upon area, this equation we already discussed in due to crushing of a spoil god in a cotter joint design procedure. We know that sigma c is equal to load upon area. Area is given to us. D2 and T we already calculated. D2 is 30 mm approximately and T is equal to 10 mm. Putting all those values, sigma c will be come out as a 133.33 megapascal, which is less than permissible value. So if the permissible value is more than the induced value, this sigma c is the induced value. Someone will ask me why I am not putting the sigma c value as a 400 megapascal, which we already calculated in a step 3 for permissible stress value calculation. So in this equation, we can consider two to three aspects. First, we can say that sigma c we already know, D2 is already known to us, and T is already known to us. In this point, we didn't need to calculate D2 or T. So this equation can be used to check that whether the component has induced value less than induced value, means produced value due to applied load of tensile load P, which is 40 kN. So whether the induced value is less than the permissible value or not. Permissible value means permitted value above which the component will fail, or equal to which a component will fail. If the induced value is less than the permissible value, then the component will save in that applied load condition. So due to that, here I am calculating sigma c value to check the component of a spoil god dimension is safe enough to bear the load of 40 kN for this case study problem. So sigma c will be come out as a 133.33 megapascal with respect to D2 or T and applied load 40 kN. It means for 40 kN, D2 and T will be safe enough to bear the load of 40 kN. Okay, for a spoil god condition. The 400 megapascal is more than the 133 megapascal. 400 megapascal is the permissible permissible compressive stresses, which I am already calculated in the step number 3 for socket rod and spoil god. So comparing these values, we can say that our design is safe to bear the 40 kN. After that, spoil god has another component, spoil god collar. So spoil god collar can fail due to shearing. So shear stress condition, due to shear stress condition, we can calculate T1. T1 is the spoil god collar thickness. D2 is already known to us, load upon area. Area will be pi D2 into T is equal to tau. Tau is known to us 100 megapascal. T is known to us 40 kN. Pi D2 is 30 mm, which we already calculated. T can be calculated from here, 4.24. Rounded off that value, T1 is equal to 5 mm. This is the procedure for spoil god section. And in step 6, design of a socket can be considered. So to design a socket section, we need to take a failures of a socket for tensile compressive and shearing due to tensile compressive and shearing. So with the help of tensile compressive shearing, we can check and calculate the different dimensions of the socket section. First, for design simplification and calculation simplification, I am going to consider failure of a socket in a tension. This equation we already discussed in a design procedure of a cotter joint. Here I am already known to, here we know that sigma t is calculated, permissible value is 200 megapascal, load is given to us. D2 is already known to us, which is the diameter of a spigot section. D1 is the outer dia of the socket section. T is the thickness of a slot, which we already calculated. So putting all those values, we can calculate D1 is equal to 34.88 mm, which can be rounded off as a 40 mm for a calculation simplification for further procedure. For in a step B, in a step 5, so in step 6, socket can be failed due to shearing also, tensile shearing and crushing. So after tensile, we can consider shearing failure. So due to shearing, load upon area is equal to shear stress. Area will be double sheared area. So 2 into D4 into D2 into C. D4 is the outer dia of a socket end, and C is the distance of a collar to a cotter end. Tau is known to us, load is known to us, D4 and C can be, C is not known to us. So C can be calculated with respect to empirical relation. C is equal to 0.75 times of D. C is equal to 15 mm, come out as a 15 mm. So putting this C, D2, P and tau, we can calculate D4 is equal to 43.3 mm. D4 can be rounded off as a 45 mm. So after calculating D4, C, D1 for a socket section, another failure can be considered in a socket section, failure of a socket due to crushing. In this point, I am going to discuss that key design, whether the dimension of a socket section is safe enough to bear a load of 40 kN. As we discussed in a design of a spigot section for last point, failure of a crushing in a spigot. Same procedure is followed in this, but here the socket section has a different cross section, a resisting area. So crushing stress is equal to load upon area. Area will be D4 minus D2 into T. This formula is already, this step is already discussed in a cotter joint procedure, design procedure. So I am not going to discuss in detail how this equation is comes from with where, and D4 is the outer dia of a socket end, D2 is the hollow section or inner dia of a socket, and T is the slot thickness in which cotter will be fitted. P is the load, sigma C is the crushing stress. P, D4, T and D2 is already known to us, which we already calculated in a previous steps. So putting all those values, sigma C will be come out as a 266 megapascal. Comparing this 266 megapascal with respect to calculated value of permissible stresses in a step 3, this 266 megapascal is less than the 400 megapascal. So after comparing these values, we can say that permissible value is less than the induced value, because this sigma C 266 megapascal is the induced value in the socket section. So if the induced value is less than the permissible value, permitted value, or we can say that, or allowable value, then the component will safe to bear the load. So we can say that design is safe for socket section also. After designing socket, spigot and rod, last step is the step number 7 for design of a cotter. So Cotter can be failed or the Cotter can be designed on the basis of only shearing, because Cotter will fail only on the basis of shearing load. So shear stress is equal to load upon area, because double shear will be occurring in a quarter section. So 2b into t. B is unknown to us, which is the mean width of the quarter. T is the thickness of the quarter section. Tau is the shear stress of the quarter. P is the load applied in the quarter joint. Shear stress is 100 megapascal. Load is equal to 40 kilonewton. Thickness T is 10 into T into B. So B can be calculated as a 20 mm. This is the mean width of the quarter section. Because the quarter is a taper kind of a section, so for design simplification, we consider a middle section as a mean value. So this is the value of a quarter joint procedure, in which each component is designed on the basis of a failure of shear crushing and shearing crushing and compressive stresses on the basis of. So I hope you understand the case study of a quarter joint. If you have any doubt regarding this case study problem, then you can comment below this video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, and thank you for watching this video.